Vernier has two sensors for measuring ultraviolet radiation, ultraviolet light. The UVA sensor measures UV radiation from 320 nanometers to 400 nanometers, and the UVB is 280 nanometers to 320 nanometers. So that's kind of the range of those values. Anything shorter than the 280 is called UVC. These do not measure that. So the reason we have two of these is depending upon where your source of UV radiation is coming from. If you're using sunlight, it tends to peak more in the UVB, and so this is one that you might end up using more outdoors. If you're using it indoors where you're creating a source of UV radiation, such as this ultraviolet light, the black light, then I might choose to use the UVA sensor for this one. It's used in several labs, in the environmental book, in the earth science manual where you're looking at UV radiation. There's a nice sunscreen lab. There's one that we have here with the sunglasses, and so we could test different lenses and see how much UV radiation is blocked out by the various lenses. So it's an easy one to be able to show you how this device works here. So I'm going to put the sensor into the clamp here, and I just want to be able to hold this relative to the UV source and hold it steady there while I do my measurements here. And so at this point I've got my sensor plugged in here, and I'm ready to plug it into my data collection device. So I've got a LabQuest 2, and I'm going to plug it into the unit there. We see that our sensor is there. It's giving me a reading right now. I have the light off. There are a couple things that I could do here. I could zero the sensor at this point if I wanted to. And now when I turn the UV source on, we see that as the light comes on there that we are getting an increase in the UV radiation. As the light warms up, it's continuing to increase. For this lab, what I'd like to do is measure the relative intensity as a terms of percent, and not milliwatts per meter squared. And to do that, I need to change the units. And so I'm going to change the units here and do it as a percent. And then I also need to run a calibration where I'm going to tell it what's 100% of the UV coming and what's 0%. And so to do that one, I need to come down and also go to the meter and do calibrate. And I'm going to do calibrate now, and I've got my light source on, and so I'm going to tap on there, and I'm going to say that currently that would be 100% of the UV radiation is reaching the sensor. So I will say done, and then I tap the keep button. So there's my first point, and at this point I'm going to cover the UV sensor with the film canister. And so I'm blocking it out, and I'm going to tell it that this point is 0%. And we'll say done, and I hit OK. And we now have the relative UV. So if I remove the film canister, it goes back up to basically 100 there. So we're now ready to test the UV absorption of some of our lenses here. So at this point, I'm going to press the collect button, and 100% of the UV radiation is reaching the sensor. So I'll just take one of our lenses from one of our sunglasses here, and I can hold it in there, and as we do that, we see the UV light level dropping there. If I pull it back out, I could try a different lens, maybe this one, put it in there, pull it back out. Then I could use maybe my own glasses here. We'll see what that does. So it's blocking out some of the UV. Not quite as much as the sunglasses. It's supposed to have a UV coating, so I'm not totally happy with that, but that's what the data are showing there. So I pull it back out, and now it's going to go back up to 100%. So at this point, probably have enough data, so I can hit stop. And we have our graph, and I might be interested in what percent of the UV was blocked out by the different lenses at this different points in time. And so I might come in here and just analyze this section of the data, come in and maybe look at the stats for that region of the graph. And I end up with the mean value, 3.7% is the only, is the UV getting through. I could come back and maybe look at the other area here. So maybe I come here, highlight that region, do the statistics there. And so I'm ending up with about 0.8%. So it's still almost all of it. And if I want to look at my regular glasses, I could come here and do that section when I'm actually looking at my regular lenses of my glasses. Maybe do the stats there. And actually, it's still about 17.8% are getting through my regular glasses there. So it's blocking out most of it, but not all of it. So again, there are two UV sensors. We have the UVB and the UVA. So depending upon what UV radiation ranges you would expect, you would use one or the other. It's used in environmental work and in earth science work. And there's some really interesting labs that do this one, and it's something that can be very relevant to students' everyday lives.